Alright, we'll try again. But if I start playing real poorly, I'm just getting weary. I like this run a lot more now. Like, I feel better about running this game than I did last night. Because now I know that all the mistakes are just silly and little. Like, there's nothing in the run that, like, is, like, concerning to me. I just, just gotta put it together. Can I get a quick check from chat, though? Will you post an S in chat if you enjoy our little sojourn into speedrunning? It's not something I do, like, Kaizo speedrunning. I feel like it's, I mean, it's definitely, I am a speedrunner, but, I know it's not something I do that often. Cool. Why doesn't any streamer have the cool S as one of their emotes? Yo, thanks for the big S's. Yeah, the super S. Yeah. Thank you, yeah. That's the fun part for me, is the science. The science of learning and of figuring out the strats and the skips and stuff. That's where I have the most fun. The run is just like publishing all my knowledge. You know what I mean? Like, I figured out the stuff and now I just gotta put it all down for you. What would 90s Twitch even be like? Oh, thanks. I mean, I've speedrun. I mean, I did a Kaizo speedrun at GDQ like multiple times. Like, I still have the Quickie 1 world record from forever ago. 3 years it's been standing now. Like, I definitely have speedrun some Kaizo in my time, but I tend to prefer just beating hacks rather than clearing them, because, as I've mentioned, in Kaizo speedrunning, when you screw up, you have to go back and do it again, and I prefer games where you don't have to do that, where you get to keep playing, like Yoshi's Island. Is a good run like that. You know, if you screw up, you don't really die most of the time. You just have to try again. Go the slow way. Recover. I like that. I like runs where I can do that. Maybe it's just from my days of playing, like, high score. Because that's the one thing I really appreciate about high score as opposed to speedrunning. Tetris, for example. If you mess up in Tetris, if I misdrop a piece and mess up the stack, there's a chance, not a guarantee, but a chance that I could just recover from that completely. And at the end of the game, it won't even matter. I still get the max out, I still get the high score, and the fact that I misdropped a couple pieces, my hand slipped a little bit, it didn't even matter in the end. In speedrunning, it always matters. Even if you get the time, even if you get the world record, all the mistakes you made never leave you alone. And that can just be psychologically different. And coming from, like, high score, it like irks me more sometimes when I make a mistake, because I'm just, like, mad at the fact that I can't ever recover from that. It was just one mistake, come on! Whoa, just take the seconds off the clock, you know, whatever. But yeah, and it's not how it works in speedruns, but like high score games, marathon high score, you could screw up as much as you want. As long as you don't game over or lose all your lives, you're fine. Keep playing. And I kind of like that. I like that about high score. That's just something that that high score has that speedrunning does not have. By its very definition, speedrunning like can't have that. Alright, made it through. Yo, Tenzo, what's up? Good to see you. Yeah, with this specific hack. I hear you. I approved all the Quickie World runs that were sitting and waiting on speedrun.com. I went through and verified them today. And I went back and watched my Quickie World run too. And I noticed one other time save. There's like a 1 or 2 second time save in Tower of Power that we didn't know about at the time. And so someone could get the world record if they just copy everything I did and also do that one thing in Tower of Power. Is high score SMW a thing? Yes and no. Yes, it's a thing. No, nobody runs it. Also, I have an unbeatable world record, so nobody can beat me. I got the max out on one life, no death, on Twin Galaxies years ago, back in 2010, 2011. It's okay. I appreciate my time that I spent with it. Fuck. It's not a good run, but it's a good run. The high score on Mario 3 is better. It's a better run because you can't repeat levels no matter what. Deathless Mario 3 high score. You cannot repeat levels. And you don't have access to certain spam strategies that you do in Mario World. The Mario World max out was made possible by a strat that I found that gets you uber amounts of points and kind of breaks the system. Otherwise, the max out wouldn't have been possible. Yes! Early orb. Okay, that makes up for a little bit of that death. I really wanted to get that because I needed to take some of the death time off. Alright, not bad. E-orb. Yeah, see, early orb is possible. It's not, like... It's kind of hard, but... It's possible. You can do it. It's not, like, really, really hard. I do wonder what the frame window for the jump you need off the carrot platform. I wonder what the maximum allowable frame window for that would be. It's probably low, but I don't know how low. There are certain setups that can create a knowable frame window of a jump. Like you can reliably create a 3-frame jump in certain setups, which is interesting. I'm not going for it. Speed games for me kind of go in two phases. At first I love it and I'm having fun, I'm finding strats. And then I'm like, ah, bruh, 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 I can't play this stupid game. And then I have fun again. And then it's just fun forever. It's like I need to get a good time to like prove to myself that I'm like doing right, and then it's fine. Like now that I have a PB I could be happy with forever, right? I don't really even need a better PB on the game. I'm just doing this now because it's fun. You know, world record is just like, eh, it's whatever. You get to be king for a day, but you only get a day. Everybody only gets a day. Even long days are still a day. I'm really surprised someone hasn't sat down and really grinded for the Quickie World Record yet. Like, it surprises me. With how popular the game is, I just assume someone, I don't know. Like eventually someone grinds out Mario 1, you know what I mean? Like, the optimization, I guess I feel like maybe the optimization of the record is like, would be appealing to somebody. To like beat that record specifically because it's as optimized as it is. I don't think I would go back for it. If someone gets the Quickie record, I'm good. I'm good. I will just congratulate them and move on. I wouldn't know, Costa. Super Ben tried for it and put it down. Wow, that surprises me. The amount of people who have tried and put it down is what really makes me surprised that it's still standing. Because any of the players who have tried for it could get it. Like there's no reason, there's nothing stopping Super Ben from being that skilled. They already are that skilled. Yump. Hey, nice, Mithroiner. It's really fun to watch people play it. It's a shame that not every hack can get that treatment, but it's really cool to see people play and have fun with something you made. That sucks. Dare the early cycle. I could have got it. I chickened out. Wow, I almost whiffed it so hard. Whew. Man, that was a hot one. I almost whiffed that so hard. That part freaks me out, man. That part. I don't know. There's something scary about it. It's too spooky for you, bro. Please don't mess this up. Thanks. You didn't mess it up. Proud of you. Did a good job, streamer. All right, moving on. Time for Big Skip City. Big Stonk City. GC7 Lord Jin Chat. Don't skip the Chuck, you'll pay for it. You will regret this. You cannot skip the Chuck. You'll regret this. Nice. Make yumps actually save time somehow. It's possible. Nice. All right. Good. Good save. Good skip. Good save. Y'all are kind. Kind and fun. Isn't that so cool? I love that skip. I found that off stream last night, and it was like 3 a.m. and Skytree and I were watching X-Files, and I'm like, I'm gonna do a run real quick. Hang on, I have to record a run with this. I was gonna call it the Mulder skip since we were watching X-Files, but I didn't figure that name would stick. So I actually do. I had a 3401. I recorded it last night with that skip because I was just like so excited. I'm like, it's 3 a.m, but I have to play. And you know what? My wife was like, go get him. That's awesome. She wasn't like, oh, you're going to stay up and play more video games? She was like, that's awesome. I hope you get the record. I love my wife. She's real great. What's up, Dan? She plays games. She's a gamester. She's good. She doesn't play the kind of games I play, but who does? She likes like Ocarina of Time and Stardew Valley and Octopath Traveler, Yooka-Laylee, Banjo-Kazooie. She likes like, you know, not like hardcore, millipede, high score marathon. There we go. Yeah, she likes RPGs and adventures, yeah. Winnable games, right? She beat Octopath Traveler. I watched her do it. She's good. She like plays, like she like actually plays games. That was fun. She was asking if we could play Fogs co-op. So we'll probably play that together at some point. That game just looks so damn cute. Freaking Fogs. Dogs stuck together. Oh man, big time loss, gamer. At least Mario is looking. Hey Mario, I'm looking at you. Look at him stare into our souls. Asking us to atone for our crimes. He looks so guilty. He knows what he did. Yeah, I like Fogs. I watched Auth play it. It's so cute. Man, two little puppers, and they're stuck together, and they're all like, bark, bark, bark. I love those little pups. I like those Fogs there. Super cute. Yeah, dedicated bark button. There need to be some Fogs, Pogs. That was close. Whew, my, oh my. Mercy. Mercy. John Darnell of the Mountain Goats makes Pogs. I guess with the new album, they put out a new Mountain Goats album and you get Pogs with it. Proving to me that John Darnell watches my stream. Thanks. Big fan of your music. A Pog Fog log? You could write the Pog Fog log on a log and then keep a log of the Pog Fog logs. Yeah, In Before Rainbow Llamas is John Darino. I often wonder sometimes if, like, is, like, someone that I know on stream, like, super famous or something, and I just, like, don't know about it because they never told me. Like, you all could be anybody. You know what I mean? Like, you could be anybody. I don't know. Ooh, that was sketchy. Sketchy. I always die there. It's tradition. Good save, mate. Good save. Shit, that was a good save. Never guess. You'll never get me alive. Yeah, probably some guy who sucks at drumming. Keep playing for exposure, pal. Maybe someday you'll get to open for the big guys. Lol. In fact, you're amazing. Yo, wow, can I have your autograph? It's amazing. You're the real Spider. Oh my gosh. Celebrity chat, let's go. Love this. I love the celebrity chat. Let's go. No, I'm Dirty Dan. You matter to us, Wayward Devil. What are you talking about? You're Wayward Devil. You're notable chat enthusiast Wayward Devil. What do you mean? Yeah, Miley Cyrus. I'm Miley Cyrus. I used to pretend to be a surfer. I was like 13. I just thought it would be cool to be a surfer, so when I would talk to people, I'd be like, I'm a surfer, I live in Hawaii. I was like 13, like, oh sorry, my mom, I remember one time I told somebody, I'm sorry, my mom made me go move my surfboard. I don't even know why, I just thought it was cool to pretend to be a surfer. I would like, go on AIM and be like, yeah, I'm a surfer, I love surfing, I go out and surf, I love the water. It's so silly. Okay, that's fine. I just thought surfing was cool. I just thought people would think I was cool if they thought I was a surfer. I wasn't any cooler. Get up there. Get up there, plumber. Oh my god, get up there, dude. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Spud. What's up? Kill screen time. My chance. I don't care. .32-34, new world record. Let's go. Let's go. Good run. Good run. Good run. Yeah. Thanks to the GGs. Thank you. What's up, Juz? Yeah, damn near a minute. Yes! Fuck you, yeah, let's go. Yes! World record. World record. World record.
Let's go.
Thank you. Thanks for the bits. Yes. All right. See you tomorrow, Pooh. Ah, oh, shit. Hell yeah. Let's go. Oh, that was great. Ah, oh, that was awesome. Great run. Thank you for the gift sub, Rubik Chaos. Got the hype train. Got our friends here. Oh man, let the credits roll. Let the hype flow. Put the stonk emotes in chat. Oh man, feels good. Feels good. I haven't gotten a world record in a bit, man. I think I went like a whole year or two without getting a world record. That's weird for me. Easy game, easy game. Oh, easy game. Oh yo, get them all over. Thank you for the bits. Hell yeah, that was a clean run, man. That was a clean run. Ballistic, what's going on? Thank you for the gift sub. Dubious Dinobot, what a pal. What a pal. All right. Yes. 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 Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Lat Mackie, thank you for 5 months. You are so cool and kind. Charlie, thanks for the gift sub. Crypt Kitty, have some cats. We need more stonk emotes for everyone. Thank you. Oh, man. Thank you so much. Ah, hell yeah. Hell yeah. Borgyman. I should be thanking you, friend. I should be thanking you. Thank you. Bobby Ocean, thank you for 51 months. Welcome back. Such friendos, I know. Such friends here today. Now, I should be thanking you. Everybody, if you like this hack, go and check out Borgyman's art. Borgyman makes great art. Has a shop. You can buy cool prints. Borgyman does great comics. Check out Borgyman's art. Make sure Borgyman gets good ups for this too. Borgyman also deserves money. Give them money. Buy their art. Hang it up on your wall. It looks great. It is great stuff. Thank you. Some Aimless Matters. Zorio, thank you so much. Yeah. Yo, get the Lorge. Get the Lorge one. Yeah, get them. Thank you. And we got the hype train.